days, so you bagged him. I'm a savage, yeah. Classy, bougie, ratchet, yeah. Sassy, moody, hey. Nasty, hey. Yeah. Hacking, stupid, whoa. What's happening, whoa. Bitch, whoa. What's happening, whoa. Bitch, I'm a savage.
Alright, y'all, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be just having a little talk with people. Today I was actually going to sit down. I've been wondering and trying to figure out lately. People have been asking me kind of questions on my Telomini app. So I was going to go through some of those questions and actually try to answer them for y'all more clearly than what I've been putting, because some of them I'll just be like half telling the answer and I'll be like, I don't feel like answering it, or I don't want to answer it. So I'm going to go through my app and I'm going to sit here and I'm going to answer these questions more clear for y'all, because some people ask really important questions, and then some people, I look at them questions and I'm like, dang, I don't know how to answer that. So, I'm going to go ahead and answer the questions for y'all. And I'm going to actually put one of my other apps on the phone that are on one of my other apps that people can ask me questions from. And I'm going to put that in one of my spam bios. So I'm going to probably post it on my story and like go look at my bio and ask me a question or something like that. But so we about to get this going. So I'm about to sit here and log into my app real quick, because I know I'm not logged into this one since I logged on my phone, because I'm recording on my other phone. And soon, guys, I hope I can get my YouTube stuff ready up and running. I'm probably gonna because once I get my room settled for college and all that, I'm probably gonna have my desk over there and then have my YouTube area over there, that way I can have my light and all that and my table and all that. And I'll be ready, because I'll be ready. So we're gonna get this started. I'm gonna come back to y'all when I actually get this up and running. So I'll be back. Alright, so I have logged in now. Let me bring this some more light up so I can see me. So, I have my profile up for y'all if I can see it. My Telomini app profile. And I'm just gonna pick random people's questions. If you know your question has been picked and you hear it in a video, give me a thumbs up that I did good, because I know some people I don't be getting them all the time. But I have a total of 362 tails. I'm going probably to do maybe 20 today. So I'm gonna pick randomly. I'm not gonna be just picking one in order. I'm gonna pick randomly. So if you hear your question, give me a thumbs up in the comments and like and share this video. Crap, this needs to be charged. This phone's about to die. That's exactly why I don't use this phone anymore, because this is my old phone, and my new phone is what I'm recording on now, and I have an XR. And this phone, the only reason I got a new phone is because this phone dies, and like I'll charge it, and then I'll be on it for like 10 minutes, and it'll be like, all right, it'll pop up with the low power mode, and I'm like, I just charged like 10 minutes ago. So that's why I have a new phone. This phone that I have now, I'll charge it and I can go a full day without having to charge it again until late on that evening. Because sometimes I'll sleep majority of the day if I'm not working or if I'm not doing anything, I'll sleep. So it really don't need to be charged like that. So that's why I'm glad I got a new phone. And I'm glad I ain't got no home button no more, because on this phone, you got still a home button. So I'm going to pick random questions and I'm just going to read them and try to answer them more clear for y'all, because some of them I'll be just half telling them. So somebody said, is there something in your life that you're really proud of? To be honest, there's a lot of things that I'm proud of in my life. I'm proud of myself because I actually finished high school and graduated. You got some kids out here who don't get to see high school who die before they even can get into high school, or you have some kids who don't make it to 12th grade, who don't make it to the end of school, like to the end of their 12 years. They either die or they either drop out, or they just don't want to finish. It's just, you got some kids who end up doing bad things and who end up somewhere they don't need to be, and they don't get to finish school. So I'm very proud of myself that I actually worked a hard 12 years to get where I am now. And I'm starting, and I'm actually my mother's first child out of two children she has. I'm the youngest, and I'm her first child that has went straight to college after high school. My sister actually waited, I think, a couple months, or she waited a year or so until she went to college. But she ended up going to New Horizons to get her certification to be a dental assistant. I'm actually going to take classes to be a chef, because that's what I want to major. I want to do chef. I want to do culinary. I kind of want to do majority of the baking side, and then like little of the cooking side, just so I know if I can, I know I can make some dishes. So I kind of want to do that as my passion. I love to get my hands dirty. I do not like to injure myself, of course, when I'm getting my hands dirty, because you know, you got people who cut themselves. I've actually seen a video where a lady was making something and she cut her finger off, and that was the worst time. That was actually the worst moment. I was shook. And then you got some people who actually, like, I know one lady, she I don't know what she made her do that, but she put her hand in the blender and started blending. I guess she forgot her hand was in the blender. And you just got people who make crazy mistakes while they're cooking. And I don't want to be that person who gets injured while having fun and getting my hands dirty. So that's why I feel like I want to do more of the baking. Because, I mean, the baking, you don't have to, if you do mixing and all that, you can mix with a KitchenAid mixer, where you don't really have to get your hands in there. You can use a dango, you can use that, and you can use a spatula or a rubber spoon to get this stuff out. But you don't want to use your hands when you're mixing with a mixer. I told them, so graduate from high school and start college I'm starting actually in the next couple of days. I'll probably start in the next, start next Thursday. It's a challenge. I've only have classes Tuesdays and Thursdays. It's not like I'll have it every day. You got some people who start college and have to take classes every day, and that's not me, because I'm only taking classes to start me off in school. Not really. Not really something. It's something easy, because I mean, I'm taking a class where I'm doing a lot of writing, and I'm not okay with that, but it's okay. I'm gonna get through it, because my mom's and my dad are gonna help me. So yeah, I'm very proud of some things that have went on in my life. I'm proud of that. I'm actually gonna make it to see 18 years of my life. I've been on this world for almost 18 years. I will hope and pray that I can make it to see 18. I just pray to God that He helps me get to that day for my 18th, that I can make it to that day, and I can see many more years of many more years on this earth. And one thing I can say, that people ask me, "Are you scared of death?" And I'm like, "I am, to be honest." So you never know when it's your time. You never know. Your time could be now. Your time could be a couple years from now. Your time could be tomorrow. You have some kids who die at young ages, and you like, I could have died at that age. But it's like, and then it's, you'll hear about some kids dying, and you'll be like, well, and then sometimes when you find out that what really happened with that kid, it's either because they were either, you got some teenagers who were involved in gangs, or you've got some people who just wanted to shoot them and kill them. But it's at this point, you just got to keep praying that you can see many more years on earth. Because you got some kids who died who haven't even lived to see middle school. I know a 9-year-old died from, I don't know if she died from COVID or if she died from a drive-by shooting. But I'm actually going to show y'all a couple videos that I saw that this boy had posted on his TikTok. And then he showed a lot of, he showed a lot of these athletes who had been taken away from Earth at these young ages. So I'll show y'all some videos of that later on in the video. Because I don't think I have them on this phone. I have them on the phone I'm recording on, so I can just airdrop them from my phone that I'm recording on to this phone. So, um, Actually, if I have the TikTok app, I can actually show y'all. I don't know if I can download it. All right, so I'm about to go to the next question. But yeah, also things I'm proud of is that my little brother is on his way to kindergarten, and I'm like shook because I remember the day that he was born. I remember when I first held him in my arms 5 years ago. He's about to see 6 years of his life. And it's crazy because this dude's about to be six and he's gonna be taller than me. Like, he's already up to my freaking, probably my stomach. If I'm standing up, he's probably already up there to my stomach. So my stomach is like right here. He's gonna be taller than me by the time he gets to maybe 10 or 11. So, yeah. So I'm gonna go ahead and download this TikTok so I can show y'all the videos. And then I'm going to go ahead and ask the next question. I'm so sorry for yawning. I'm tired. I slept majority of today. I'm really tired because I tried to sleep before 12 o'clock. But my mom was like, hey, Naya, can you bring your computer down so you can try to pay for your class again? I'm like, can a girl sleep? So I'm sorry if I'm yawning. If I look tired, I am tired. I just wanted to do a video real quick for y'all so I can post some more content. Somebody asked, would you ever be a vegan? I told them, not at all. Not a chance. I seen vegan people eat, and some vegan people starve themselves. Like, I've seen, my friend is vegan, and she starves herself. Like, she eats nothing. And you know, vegans can eat any, like, type of vegetable. But when you eat in only one color vegetable, like, she only eats green vegetables. I cannot do that. And to be honest, I don't even like eating vegetables, especially if they're not cooked. Like, I know I would not eat broccoli if it's not cooked. And you see some salads come with raw broccoli. You would not catch me eating that. I can eat raw carrot. I can eat cooked carrot. I can eat zucchini. I don't eat squash. I tried squash. I don't like squash. I don't like cucumbers. I don't like celery. I don't like tomatoes, even though tomatoes are considered a vegetable and a fruit. But some things I'm very picky with. I'm very picky when it comes to vegetables. So that's why I would never become a vegan, because I wouldn't be able to handle it because I'm very picky. So that's why I would never do vegan. I would never go vegetarian. I would never go, you got people who, I mean, I would be able, this one girl, it's a word for it. And it's when you just eat fish, like, so let me see. Pescatarian. A pescatarian is someone who doesn't eat meat but does eat fish. So I could do that because I love me some fish. I love me some tilapia. I love me some salmon. I love me some catfish. I can eat fish for days. But you will not catch me eating any veggies. I just can't sit here and eat veggies every day. Like, that's just not me. The next question is, let's see. Somebody said, what's the perfect place for a vacation? The perfect place for a vacation is an island like Bahamas or Jamaica, because that's like so romantic. I can say a family vacation, that's the best place to go for a family vacation, is to the islands, because the water is so pretty, and you get to like experience new, like, stuff that you don't see and hear in the States, like the Caribbeans and all that. It's all way on an island. You don't get to experience that on freaking in Virginia or in Hampton or that, or North Carolina. You don't get to experience that in Newport News or South Carolina. You don't experience that stuff you don't see here. You'll see that only out there. That's why I said that's a perfect place for a vacation, because you get to experience new stuff out there and get to look at a change of scenery for once. This next one is, I said, would you rather go back to age 5 with everything you know now, or know everything your future self will learn now and why? First of all, kind of stumbled on that question because I was like, what? That makes no sense. But it's basically asking, would you rather go back to age 5 and everything you know now, know that at the age 5, or would you want your future self to learn new things? Oh, no, no, no. It says, or know everything your future self will learn now. So basically, it's asking you, would you rather go back to the age of five? I gotta rephrase that. Go back to the age of five and know everything you know now, or learn what your future self knows now. So would you rather learn what your future self knows now? So this is asking you, if your future self knows a lot now, would you want to learn what they know now, or would you rather go back to age five and know what you know now? Basically, it sounds confusing, but I'm trying to make it as perfect as I can. But I said knowing everything my future self will learn now, because it's better to know more than to know less. Because it doesn't matter which way I go back, I'm going to learn something regardless. And I'd rather learn more than I want to learn less, because at the end of the day, you got some kids out here who don't know anything. So that question would be hard for somebody else to answer if they don't know anything. Next question. Somebody asked, is there something you use every day? Of course. I use my phone and I use my AirPods literally every day, every single day. If I'm not using my phone, I'm either downstairs talking to my mom or playing with my dog or watch TV. If I'm not on my AirPod, my AirPods are in my ear, they're on the charger, one of the two. But majority of the time, they're in my ear and my phone is in my hand. Somebody said, what are your feelings on marriage? My personal opinion, I can't wait to get married. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with the one that I know is out there for me one day. I actually was in a relationship 2 years ago and broke up with him on my dad's birthday. Was depressed as all get out. My dad was like, what's wrong with you? And I just was like, nothing. I cannot have to. Like, no, I just broke up with him. And actually, I actually will not regret dating him, because I got in trouble with him and I did stupid stuff with him. And that's what you want to do in your relationship. You want to get in trouble with each other. You want to do crazy things together. But I kind of missed that relationship, because I actually really liked that dude. I really liked this dude. And it was crazy that we broke up the way we did. I went to a different school. I went to school together, but then his mom and dad put him at a different school. So it just, our relationship just turned a whole nother level. So it just took it was just whatever. I broke up with him because he was acting kind of shady. Like, he wanted to talk to somebody else there. So I was like, you can have them. I'll be by myself then. So yeah, that's how that ended. But I can't wait to marry the love of my life when I find that person one day in my life. But right now, it's probably not gonna happen no time soon. But yeah, somebody asked me a while back, how did I feel about gay marriage? I don't have an offense to that. I love actually gay marriage. Gay marriage is so cute. But one of my friends actually, she's like, how do you feel about, like, cause I was in class one day and some girl that she was new to school. And she's one of them quiet and one of them weird girls. She came and sat. She had sat beside me because there was open desk beside. So I just happened to look at her, like, just was sitting there looking. And I was looking around. It happened as glance. It wasn't a purposely glance, but it was like an accident. Like, it was just a glance. I had glanced at her phone and she was watching gay porn. And I'm like, that is, to me, for you to be watching gay guy porn, that's just nasty. So I can get out. Because the way she was watching it, it's like, I'm not gonna describe it in a nasty way, but like, you got two thingies and you got things hanging down. When you're going, they're just touching. That's just nasty. I just can't see how people can watch it in school. Like, I know you can watch it your own time in your room and all that, but don't watch it in school when you got kids around you who are just glancing and just happen to look at you. I happen to look in your area and see you watching it in the middle of class, in the middle of a lesson, though. It's just nasty. So I don't like that, but I don't have an opinion. I don't have a bad way on gay sex. I mean, not gay sex, but gay marriage. It's cute. They're cute. So we're going to go to the next question. Somebody asked me this question was a while back. It says, which games do you have on your phone? I said, I have a lot of games, but some of them I make money playing them. I'm actually going to show y'all some of the games you actually make money off of. This one right here that I have on my phone is called Lucky Dice. basically you just roll a dice, and sometimes whatever it's like not Monopoly, what's that one game, Candyland and all them, where the box you hop, but you put your character in whatever box you land on. So basically this is like something like that, but you go in a circle, whatever square you land on, it may be nothing on it, it may be a coin on it where you earn some coins, or maybe a little green coin where it means money. So I'm gonna show y'all what it looks like, because this is a game. So this game, you can make money. As you see in the corner up here, it has the little, hold up. As you see up here in the corner, it has a little dollar money sign, and I see it has zero balance. Because this game, I actually have on my phone I'm recording on now. All the games I'm going to show you are on my phone that I'm recording on. And whatever I download on my phone I'm recording on, downloads on this phone, which I don't know why. So that's one game that I can make money off of. It's called Lucky Dice. Then I have this one that's called Plinko Master. And you can already see by looking at the thing, it has a little dollar sign right there, the money sign. So you guys see it's a money game. This game, it's kind of, some of these games, it takes you a while to actually get to, like, because you when you play some of these games, you have to get to like a certain amount of money in order to cash it out to a PayPal account, or you can do that, exchange it for an Amazon gift card. This one, you just tap a whole bunch of balls. I'm probably gonna show you you just tap a whole bunch of balls, and they'll go into the bottom over here. And you see the money one is right there in the purple. I almost had that one. I didn't get nothing. So you see, and of course your money collection goes up here, and your coins, and it tells you how many balls you have right here left. So yeah, that's one game that I know does make money off of. There's one right here that has, I think it says 8,000 plus levels, and I'm on like 100 some level on this phone. I don't play much games because I play on my phone majority. But this one you can make money off of, and I'm actually on my phone. I'm playing on my phone right here. I actually have $98 and like some cents. Cause once you get to a certain amount of money on some of these games, you can cash out. So like this one, why is it not showing money? Maybe this isn't the one that I downloaded. Hold up a second. That's the Saga, that's why. It's not the same one. This is the one, I'm sorry. Cause I was like, hold on, I have two games that are the same name, but one is a Saga and one is a regular game. Saga, you can earn money off that. So this one right here, you can earn money off of. As you see, once it loads up, I can show you. So right here, as you see, I made $6.01 on just one level. So if I X out of this, basically you'll see the little money sign down here, and you'll see it. And when you click on it, it tells you how much money you have and how much money you made playing the game. So I'm gonna X it out, and I'm gonna click on the money. And it tells you how much you made just playing a level. So I'm gonna go play level two, and I'm gonna see how much money I get next. So now I made $3. Now once you get, because it tells you you need to have $100 to exchange Amazon gift card cash with PayPal. Once you get to like close enough to cashing out, it will take forever to get you to 100. Like I was sitting at $97 for like 3 days. Then I finally went up to $98 last night. And I've been sitting at that since last night. Like it literally takes you forever to get to that 100 once you get close enough to cash out. It's some other games that you can make money off of, but I'm not gonna show you all of them because I don't want to give my little secrets away. People try to play them. I'm gonna show y'all one more that I know gives money away. And then like my eyeshadow, I'm trying to look the most. I know, I see some girls who have the long hair, they got the long curly hair, and they do like a little swoop in the front. I tried to do this today and yesterday. It was cute, but I don't think I want to start wearing my hair like this because I don't know. I be putting too much gel up here though, cause I be big in the morning. I still got it in my hair. I'm like, dang. This one right here is called Word Connect. And then I'm gonna show y'all. I'm trying to show y'all what it looks like, but it takes forever to. So this is what it looks like. It's like the same game I just showed you. And of course, you see the little money, little thing right here. And of course, I have no dollar. I have nothing right now. So I'm gonna show y'all right now. And my friend was like, "That's smart because now that I have these games on both phones, I can play and I can cash out." And I would have like $200 in my account. But if I played both of them, all three of these games I had to show you, or the two games I showed you that I got like $9 on it now, and I got this one, I just earned $6. By the time I get to the cash out price, I'll be able to, because this one says you need, oh wow. This one moves that you need to have 100 to cash out. No, because my phone here says I need to have 50. I'm guaranteed it went up too. Watch. So I just earned $3 off this. So I have 913 now. Both of the games I just showed you, I have 913. That's my total. Because it tells you your balance at the bottom. So if I can get to 100 on this game and 100 on the other game, that'd be 200. And I'm also at 100. I'm almost at 100 on one of these games. On this one, I'm recording on, and then I'm at almost 50. So once I had like 350 on that, shoot, girl, hustle. So those are my little games I do. And of course, once you finish, you'll just cash it out on PayPal. You'll just cash it out up here, and you know, of course, it will tell you. Oh, you got 100 from such and such game. So, yeah. I did say I was going to do, like, 20 different questions, but I don't think I'm going to do that because I'm already, like, 25 minutes, and I still had my intro that I did. So, now I was, like, for at least 3 or 4 minutes. So, I'm probably going to go ahead and do probably 2 more questions, and I'm going to end the video. And I'll get on it tomorrow night or maybe on Saturday and do the other half. Anyway, apps take forever to load. But I was just on the app, it was take forever to load. Like, come on now. Alright, so let's see. I don't remember what questions I asked or how many I asked. I probably can count. Hold up. So the 7 questions, I'm gonna do 3 more, and I'm gonna do 2, 3 more. So 7, 8, 9, 10. I made 3 more. I'm gonna do the other 10 on Saturday. So my next question, my last 3 questions, I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of shut them out. I'm gonna answer them as quickly as I can. One question somebody asked me was, "Would you prefer natural or lots of makeup?" I said natural because I actually, you don't need a lot of makeup to look pretty for somebody. If they don't like your natural looks, they can leave and go on about their business. So I prefer natural because I like how I naturally look. I can make my hair look pretty and put up a whole bunch of lip gloss and maybe put some lashes on and do my eyebrows and still look cute. So I don't need makeup to make me look pretty. So that's why I said I like my natural look. Is there a certain way you prepare for a date? Somebody asked me that. Yes, makeup sometimes. No, I don't cake my face up like some people do. Hair first, makeup, hair first. Then I get dressed, and then shoes, and then smell goods, and then my purse, and then I'm on my way. So it's not typically like it takes a process and all that. It's not a long time. It takes a process. Sometimes it takes maybe a long process for me to get ready, but not all the time. It don't take me all the time for me to get ready. So I'm very quick on that, especially with my hair, because if I know what exactly I'm doing with my hair, I'm like this. But if I don't know what I'm wearing, I'm like, I may look a little confused for a minute or so. Somebody said, "What's the most relaxing pace you have ever been?" I think it's supposed to say relaxing place, not pace. Relaxing place you have ever been. I said, if you mean place, Myrtle Beach, if you mean pace, I'm not sure what you mean by that. But by place, I feel like Myrtle Beach is relaxed because you can cheer, chill and everything. You know, you're not, nobody's bugging you. You're just keep to yourself. And there's nothing that's keeping you behind or anything. So I say that my most relaxing place I've ever been is Myrtle Beach because you get to just chill out there and enjoy the weather. It's nice and hot. You can go to the pools that they got out there. They got a NASCAR place out there. So yeah, Myrtle Beach is the best place I would go that I've ever been that has relaxing. But yeah, so those are my best relaxed place. So I want y'all to make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe. I will end this video on another note. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Leave a comment if I asked your question, answered it clearly enough to you. And make sure you just put a thumbs up, share, comment, like, subscribe to my post notification bell to be notified when I post a video. And I want you to smash the comments and smash the like button. And I will see y'all in the next video. And we out. See y'all later, fam. Bye, subscribers.
No face, no case. That I hit the first night, first date. Put that thing all on my face. Do what I say, what I say. No Instagram.
For free, I give out daps and them hoes, but no ones for me. Cause that type of shit don't faze a player. This type of shit is what make a hater.
Hey, when you got it out of mud, yeah.